While I was walking around here in New York looking at the sights, and I come to a place where it said skating, and I calculated I'd go in and have a skate. Yes, sir. I used to be right smart on skates when I was a boy back home. I could outskate any feller on our mill pond. Well, I got on the inside, and feller said to me, "Can you skate?" I told him I calculated as how I could. Well, he called a little boy, and he strapped a pair of little toy automobiles on my feet and said, "Now, don't forget the skate, boy." Well, I calculated I'd show them city folks a few papers, and by gosh, I did. First thing I calculated I would do would be the two-step, and I done it. Just two steps, that was all. Well, that floor was slicker than greased lightning, and them wheels were the most uneasy little critters. One foot went northeast and the other went southwest, and by gosh, I don't know where the rest of me went to. I done the spread eagle, the figure eight, the inside roll, the outside roll, and the Philadelphia twist all to once. Well, when I come to, there was a lot of fellas standing around me. One had ice water, another had liniment, and another had something to smell. And they got me on my feet and told me to try it over again. But my ambition for skating was gone, and so was my watch and chain. Well, I got them little automobiles off my feet, and I throwed them at that boy just to show him I didn't forget him, and I got out of there. First thing I seen when I got out was a feller falling all over the sidewalk, and I said to a gentleman standing there, "What's the matter of him?" And he said, "Well, I guess he's got a skate on." I guess, but gosh, he had. That's the way it acted on me.